Hi, and welcome back to the Homeschooling Homesteader. Today I'm going to be going over week 7 of cycle 1 with classical conversations and what we went over in class for the review for the parents and maybe some ideas for tutors if you're having trouble planning your week. So here we go. I'll start with the timeline hand motion. So we start with Jesus the Messiah. So we're going through 43 through 49 if you have the timeline cards. So Jesus the Messiah, I'm doing the sign for Christianity, so Jesus, and then I do an M with my hand and do a sash, Messiah, because he's like the king. Pentecost, you cover your mouth and then you do this, like with the flaming tongues, Pentecost in the early church. And then persecution spreads the gospel, you're making a G with your hand, and you're just doing this, persecution spreads the gospel. Herald's temple destroyed by Titus. So I'm doing a T and like I'm destroying the temple. So Herod's temple destroyed by Titus. Diocletian, I make a D. Diocletian divides the Roman Empire. I'm making a C for Constantine legalizes Christianity. And then India's Gupta dynasty. They were really rich, so this is the sign for gold. India's Gupta dynasty. So one more time. Jesus the Messiah, Pentecost in the early church, persecution spreads the gospel, Herod's temple destroyed by Titus, Diocletian divides the Roman Empire, Constantine legalizes Christianity, India's Gupta dynasty. Okay? So for math, we have the 13s. The tune is Jolly Old St. Nicholas, and for this, this is very stick in the sand. We just did a volcano with our voices, so I had the kids sit down and they started out whispering 13, 26, 39, 52, 65, 78, 91, 104, 117, 130, 143, 156, 169, 182, 195. So they started out whispering and they were a volcano erupting and they got louder and louder and they were screaming 195. So that was what we did for math. It was very easy, but the kids really loved it. So we'll probably be doing that some other way in the next few weeks. For history, tell me about Hinduism and Buddhism in India. For the song, there's some motions. So Hinduism developed around 1500. So you do three fives real fast. 1500 BC and is known for karma. So you make a K and you do a circle because karma is what goes around, comes around. Reincarnation. So it's like you're reborn. Reincarnation and the caste system. You know, the levels of your lot in life, kind of. And then Buddhism, you do a belly for Buddha. Buddhism, founded in the 6th century BC. Buddhism teaches self-denial, make a cross, you're denying yourself, as the path to enlightenment. Okay, so those are the motions. I don't know if I can sing this on key because it's one of those songs that's really low, or if you go an octave higher, it's really high. So I'm just going to pick a key. So it goes, Hinduism developed around 1500 BC and is known for karma, reincarnation, and the caste system. Buddhism, founded in the 6th century BC, Buddhism teaches self-denial as the path to enlightenment. Okay, so that's the history. Geography is the Roman Empire. So it's Hispania, Gaul, Germania, Alexandria, and Carthage. And we just did the markers and maps yet again because it is kind of in one little area. And the kids really enjoy, like, I think they feel like they're a teacher when they get to use the expo marker because it's a special marker that they don't usually get. So we just keep doing the markers and the maps because my kids love that. So we might switch it up once we go to regions or like continents. I'm sure I'll do something different. But for now, I'm sticking with the markers and maps because it's a hit with at least my class. Okay, science. What are some ways animals reproduce? Live birth, eggs, fragmentation, and budding. And I could not think of a song that went with this, and so I just went with a like chant, and I said it, and the kids repeated. And so I said, what are some ways? What are some ways? Animals reproduce. Animals reproduce. Live birth and eggs. Live birth and eggs. Fragmentation. Fragmentation. And budding. And budding. So that's also very stick in the sand this week. I couldn't think of anything else, so I just thought a chant, and if you do it those 7 times, then it'll eventually stick and the kids will get it. So the prepositions that we're learning this week are in, inside, into, like, and near. And so it's in, like your fingers are in your hand, inside, you just move it forward, into, going back into it, like, what was like? Hang on, in, inside, there's a fly, into, I think it's like, and near. Near is just beside you. So in, inside, into, like, near. Okay? And then the third declension noun endings. Oh, this is the first week of those again. So I'm using my cheat sheet. Once again, I print out, these are individual printouts that Carolyn J. Baltazar puts on the CC Connected. And so they're bigger versions of the snake, the knee, the gym, the net. And so it really helps the kids because my kids are not really reading anyway. And so to have a picture of something to help them produce the correct sound and form their mouth around the correct sound, but also something that they can look at since they can't actually read, is really helpful for our class. And I leave those at school, so that's why I don't actually have those with me whenever I make these videos. But I have printed these out and I put them on our board with sticky tack every week. So, and the third declension song is also Bingo was his name. Oh, so it's the same tune as first declension, which can be a little bit confusing, but other CC moms have thought of different ways to like start the different declensions and get it right. So anyways, we're going to go through these. Singular, various, there actually isn't a specific one. It changes, so you just say various. So every week I write that with a marker board for this spot by the nominative noun ending. So various, is, like hiss. You're back to a knee. We've seen that quite a few times. E, and then M like a gem, and E as a net. So it helps you pronounce the correct E sound. So various, is, E, M, E. Various, is, E, M, E. Various, is, E, M, E. Singular third declension. Okay, now the plural side. We have ace again, we've seen that. We have like vacuum, we've seen that. This was a new one in third declension. We're combining a little bit of this word and a little bit of this word. So for rib, that's giving us the ib sound, and then the plus sign is giving us the us, so it's ibus. Ibus is the dative third declension noun ending. And then we have another ace, and then another ibus, okay? So it's ace, ibis, ace, ibis, ace, ibis, ace, ibis, ace, ibis, ace, ibis, plural third declension. Okay, so that's our Latin for week 7. Oh, and that was it. And then we did fine arts. It was the first week of Tin Whistle, which was actually really, really good in our class. I was so proud of our kids. I think what really helped is we established the ground rules at the beginning, and they kind of knew. I actually did where if they blew their tin whistle out of turn, then and I let them know ahead of time. If you blow your tin whistle out of turn when we're out of, if you're not in the ready position, then I will take your tin whistle for the end of class and then you get a straw. So they could still practice, but that it wouldn't make any noise. And just telling them that at the beginning totally worked, and they knew I was serious, I guess, and I didn't have to replace a single tin whistle with a straw, and I was very proud of my class. So great job. And yeah, that was it for review. We did Play-Doh because it's a class favorite again. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. And I hope you have a wonderful week. Happy homeschooling.